Hey guys, what's up? It's Dragonfly Jake, and today we are going to be talking about three things that should be added to DAYZ Standalone. Now, these three things are there's many things that should be added, right? It's not just these three things. These are just three things that I've seen recently, and I'm actually thinking about turning this into a series, so make sure you subscribe to check out more things in the future that I think should be added to DAYZ Standalone, and heck, add a comment with things you think should be added with a detailed response of why and how it should be implemented, and maybe you'll get featured in a video. Anyways, on to the first thing, and that is this DAYZ menu. From back in 2014, this was a concept. Recently, a user on Reddit referenced it and said that they're hoping with new beta or like beta updates, they could implement a new style menu. And with the new implementation of a new UI and new engine, and I mean everything coming with the beta in 0.63, it's not going to be that much of a surprise if some sort of new menu is implemented. But we were specifically hoping for one that is styled somewhat like this. So as you can see, there's a survive tab, a travel tab, a killed tab. And I like how there's not a killed amount of people. There is a reputation thing for hero. But if it said killed people, that would encourage people to just get as many kills as they could. But yet it says killed and an amount of zombies, which that's kind of cool to like give. I mean, like imagine if you saw like 350 kills on zombies. Like that'd be pretty cool. And like imagine if there was like some achievements DAYZ gave you for the amount of zombies killed. Like that kind of stuff would be really encouraging. And just might bring people to the game, stuff like that. It tells you the amount of time you survived, which maybe encourages players to be a little bit more passive and survival-wise. The amount of time traveled, which adds a little bit more fun to the running simulator DAYZ seems to be. So that kind of stuff just really boosts the feel of the game, and it's all it is simple implementations of a menu from data from your character in the game. The only difficulty would be that between different private servers, of course, you have different characters between first person, you know, all these different types of servers. It would have to, I guess, only show your current character, or maybe you could scroll through different characters, and then among scrolling through those characters, it would also say, "Hey, this character Jimmy is from the server Chipotle Bandits. This character is from DAYZ Underground." I don't know. That kind of stuff I think would be very, very neat. It also has a reputation hero, which, to be honest, you could do an entire video based on like getting the hero versus bandit thing. I might do one of those in the future. Let me know if you want me to. But personally, I don't have a developed opinion on how a system would work to make you decide if you were a hero or a bandit. If you have any ideas, seriously, leave them in the comment section down below. I read every single comment. Alrighty, anyways, on to the next thing, and this is basically an entire topic around when you die and how that should be handled. Personally, it's a little bit weird when you die. Pretty much if like the shot kills you, all that happens is your screen goes black. Like there might be like an ow sound if you die like a millisecond after the impact, but generally all that happens is your screen goes black and it says you are dead. That's a little unrealistic. Like if you get shot in the head, I get it, you know, you're gonna go unconscious instantly when you're dead. But when you get shot in the chest, if you don't go unconscious, you're probably going to grab your chest, fall to the ground for a couple seconds, and, you know, I mean, this is kind of gory, so close your ears if you don't want to hear it. But gurgle on your own blood. That's a very common thing you see in movies that are accurate. Blood would fill your throat and all this. I don't want to talk too much about it, but basically, when you get shot in the chest or in the back or in the abdomen, even if you're going to die for certainty, even if it's in the next couple seconds or minute, there's going to be more that happens than just a black screen, right? So this kind of kills the immersion when you die, and adding a simple thing like gurgling on your own blood or grasping your chest or falling face first into the ground and getting a face full of dirt or some sounds, falling. I mean, imagine like you get shot and all of a sudden your character falls backwards and flings his gun, you know, a foot away, and there's like a loud sound. Not only would it make it more interesting for the person that shot you, I think they're already adding some new death animations, but for yourself, you know, there would be a little bit of fun and immersion involved in your death. Because currently it's a bit frustrating to just go from this immersion fighting, intense gunfight, to just black screen, you were dead, right? Grasping your chest could add some cool scariness to the game, maybe even some humor. I mean, imagine a giant, blah, and you're gurgling, and there's this gurgle sounds, and there's some blood on your screen, loud noises as you reel over dead. I mean, that would be really neat, and I don't know, it would just keep me interested in the game, and I would really, really enjoy it, and I think a lot of other people would too. And imagine if, like, even if you got shot in the chest, imagine if there was five different types of deaths you could have, so that when you die, there's still a little bit of reward. And I don't mean reward, but I guess I mean, like, there's something to keep you interested. You know, wow, I got the rare fall in your face and go, screw you. I don't know. These are really random stretches of things, but these are ideas for DAYZ, which I have a lot of, and apparently a lot of other people do too. The third idea I have is helicopters, and I say I have, this is talked about by many, many people, but basically this is a touchy subject considering the transportation and possibly destruction value of a helicopter. I won't talk about helicopters too much because really it's as simple as a helicopter would have to be very, very difficult to get and use. It should take a team of people getting... Maybe you have to go all the way to Riffy to retrieve your helicopter blade. You have to go all the way to Tizzy to actually find the helicopter pad where the body of the helicopter is. Maybe the engine is all the way down on the coast next to the car line. Maybe in Belota Airfield. That's the only place you can find the rare rear rotor. I don't know. But it would definitely need to be incredibly difficult to build the helicopter. It would take a lot of fuel, and it would sort of be like a giant in-game mechanic. Besides for people to run to the coast and kill fresh spawns, it would give squads something to do. But there should only be maybe one helicopter per server, maybe two, and only one of them can shoot. I don't know. Helicopters are a very touchy subject. I think they will definitely be out of the game. Like, the devs have talked about them many times. But how they're implemented, whether it's just a couple little birds on the map, a giant attack helicopter, who knows? Either way, it needs to be very, very difficult, and I think that's widely agreed upon. If you guys have anything to criticize or any sort of more details you'd like to add to the three concepts I talked about, make sure to leave those down in the comment section down below. Any other ideas you have, make sure to leave in the comment section, and maybe I'll choose them and use them in the next video, including a shout-out to you. Here's the shout-outs for the three people I did use. The menu was made by JoeySlucky22. That's the user for that. Gurgling on your own blood, and those kind of animations were actually talked about by Bethesdur. And both these were found on Reddit, and number three, helicopters, is talked about like a million different people, so I'm not going to reference anybody, except myself. I'm so cool. Just kidding, that was sarcasm. Yeah. Anyways, thank you guys for watching. Make sure to drop a like if you liked the video. Subscribe for more DAYZ content, and I hope to see all of you in my next video.